In other news, streaming apps like Netflix and Spotify may soon be slapped with a 12% value-added tax here in the Philippines. That's after the House of Representatives approved a measure seeking to impose taxes on foreign digital services. 254 lawmakers voted in favor of the bill, 4 opposed, while 1 abstained. The measure covers subscription-based digital services, online advertisement services, and other electronic services that can be delivered through the internet. But educational services, including online courses and webinars of private institutions, they will be exempted. The bill aims to level the playing field between traditional and digital businesses and generate revenue for government. But progressive lawmakers call the bill another regressive tax measure. Malacañang appoints former Trade Assistant Secretary Attorney Ernesto Perez as the new Director General of the Anti-Red Tape Authority, or ARTA. Perez says his appointment came at an opportune time as it would allow the agency to further their mandate of removing red tape and boost the ease of doing business in the Philippines. He also vows to do his part to make the Philippines more attractive to investors and help the Marcos administration achieve its goal of streamlining government agencies. Perez succeeds Attorney Jeremiah Belica, who served as ARTA chief from July 2019 to June 2022. From one government office to another in less than a month, lawyer Jose Arturo Tugade has been appointed chief of the Land Transportation Office by Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista. The son of former Transport Chief Arthur Tugade was recently named acting general manager of the Manila International Airport Authority by Malacañang. But Bautista says Tugade was better suited for the very challenging job at the LTO given his experience in management and litigation. Bautista adds they have asked for the indulgence of the president and explained the gravity of the situation at the controversy-ridden agency. The palace has yet to release a statement on Tugade's new post. Trade expansion eyed by the Philippines and the European Union after years of strained relations, as Warren de Guzman also tells us, EU lawmakers might visit Manila next year.
The last Philippine administration had testy relations with the European Union when EU lawmakers and former President Rodrigo Duterte traded barbs over the human cost of the Philippine war against drugs. There was even concern those human rights issues might lead to the forfeiture of trade benefits enjoyed by the Philippines under the Generalized Scheme of Preferences, or GSP+. Under the scheme, some 6,000 Filipino goods enter the EU duty-free. It appears both sides are now on friendlier terms as the Philippines prepares to renew its GSP Plus status in 2023. But European Union Ambassador to the Philippines, Luc Veron, says the EU Parliament will have the last say on the matter.
Definitely there are issues of concern that have been discussed between the Philippines and the European Union. Related to the past concept of the war on drug. And it's very interesting to see that the new administration has reformulated a war on drug that is different from what was in the past. So there is a new policy. And I think what is so also very important is that we can have this conversation between the Philippines and the EU. So in other words, the quality of the conversation is very important. So if we have issues of concern, if the Philippines have issues of concern, we can certainly discuss it.
The European Union had a monitoring mission on the application of GSP Plus in the Philippines in February and March, and Veron expects the report to be presented to the European Parliament by either the end of 2022 or early 2023. Veron is confident there is enough there to keep talks going, and adds the European Union is also looking to resume free trade agreement or FTA talks with one ASEAN nation, and Malaysia, Thailand, and the Philippines are being considered. He adds the recent visit of Filipino lawmakers to Europe, led by Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, was also appreciated.
I am not making predictions, but it's very important that we keep our focus on the objective. I said that there is a reflection or a period of thinking in the European Commission as to which country to restart first the FTA. And definitely the Philippines is part of the mix of countries. But I cannot speak at this stage as to which country will come first. I'm very happy that we were able to restart the process and that there will be a visit of the European Parliament to the Philippines next year, I guess, as a reciprocation of the visit that just took place.
Veron delivered the keynote address at the 2022 European-Philippine Business Dialogue hosted by the European Chamber of Commerce in the Philippines, where a large group of European diplomats met with Philippine government officials to exchange 11 advocacy papers covering multiple sectors such as tourism, energy, and financial services. The Philippine Department of Trade and Industry was on site to represent government, and it says the Marcos administration will do its part to expand trade. The EU shares the utilization rate of GSP Plus in the Philippines was at 76% in 2021. In terms of total trade, the EU says the Philippines is outpaced by all other ASEAN members, with Vietnam and Thailand's trade at 2 to 3 times that of the Philippines. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.